iPhone 12 Pro Max with a 6.7-inch XDR display delivering high brightness, a watercolor range, and the best color accuracy in the industry. It's powered by their latest A14 Bionic chip, capable of handling the Pro 12-megapixel camera system with the new sensor shift optical image stabilization, their new Apple Pro RAW, and soon to be a standard 5G. While it's no secret that with great power comes great responsibility, the Pro Max is capable of providing up to 20 hours of video playback and up to 80 hours of audio playback with its 3,687 mAh battery. Definitely a great daily driver for those who use their phone for work. My name is Andres and I'm here to unbox this new behemoth, test the video and photography capabilities, and show you the customizations this phone is capable of delivering with the new iOS 14 update. Apple this year have decided to go minimal. The unboxing experience hasn't changed much, and like any of the other previous years, one of the most satisfying parts about the new iPhones is the removal of the plastic. Now, at first sight, you will find this new beautiful Pacific blue color Apple has been working on, along with their new alignment magnet inside for the MagSafe feature. And of course, not to forget the three cameras on the textured matte glass back, which include a wide lens, an ultra wide lens, and a tele lens. Turning it around, you will realize the different type of paper cover they put on these new screens. And yes, I say new because the new ceramic shield Apple has been working on for the past year claims to be the toughest glass ever on a smartphone. If you haven't realized it yet, the company has made a change to its stainless steel frame. Yes, it's now squared. Apple have decided to make a departure from the old round edge design, and while I'm no big fan of the flat edges, I've got to say, Apple, you've nailed it with this one. Further on, you might have guessed how Apple went minimal, and that is by removing the USB-C charging brick they were providing last year with the 11 models. To Apple's defense, they did state within the event about their new responsible packaging. I'm guessing this is part of it. But the question to be asked this year is, Apple, how different is the Pro Max compared to the Pro? Is it worth the $100 premium you charge? The biggest feature Apple have introduced this year with the Pro Max model is the sensor shift optical image stabilization in wide mode. In other words, they've implemented the ability for the sensor to float inside the camera to adapt to your movements and keep that image steady. And while that is a big change for film enthusiasts, the $100 premium doesn't just cover that. Aside from the form factor, the 2.5x telephoto lens with f2.2, the 5x optical zoom range and the digital zoom up to 12x are ingredients constituting the $100 premium price being paid. But I've got to say, the craziest feature out of them all being delivered with the Pro line is Apple Pro RAW. That's it, you've heard it, shooting RAW within a phone. Now, enabling Pro RAW only takes a couple of clicks and it's fairly simple to use. Simply head to the settings, camera, formats, and within the photo capture section, enable Pro RAW. Once you're in the camera app, you can toggle the RAW feature to turn it on or off. The best part about this experience for content creators like myself is the ability to airdrop these to your Mac and being able to edit them using Lightroom Classic. But do not fear, you can also use the Lightroom app and do this on the go. While I am no minimalist, I do enjoy having a clean looking phone, as well as being able to solely include my favorite apps and widgets within one page. Having a minimal iPhone setup is pretty simple, and luckily iOS 14 has made this possible for us. Having your own custom icons can be a tedious task to implement, but it's fairly simple. Just make sure you have the icons you wish to activate within your photos library. Open the Shortcuts app, click on the plus button, then add an action, scripting, open app, choose the app you wish to have a cover for. For example, I'm going to choose Snapchat. Click on share. Then you can go ahead and add to home screen, give it a name, click on this little icon right here, choose a photo. I have the Snapchat right here. Click add, next, Snapchat again, done. And now it will be added to your home screen right here. And voila, there you have it. You can get rid of this one right here. Remove app, remove from home screen. I've taken the time to create different icon sets for a minimal look to match the color of the textured matte glass back you've chosen for your phone. You can find these in the description down below. Just make sure to visit my Selfie store at Andres Vidoza. A quick shout out to Newer for sending me their new motorized slider. Thank you, Newer, for making this video possible and allowing me to make cool smooth b-roll for this video. While I do realize the price of iPhones are fairly costly, I personally have to admit that this year's model is probably the coolest one yet. But is it worth the upgrade? That is for you to decide. Hopefully this video has given you a better perspective on the newest and ultimate iPhone Apple has to offer. That being said, I gotta go do homework. Oh, and Apple, I will definitely see you next year at the release of the iPhone 13. Take care, guys.